I'm in my mom's basement right now. I'm home for the holidays, but that doesn't mean that the jokes stop. Here's one. Why can't you have a nose that's 12 inches long? Well, because then it would be a foot. I know what you're thinking. Nice one, dad.com. But I'm not your dad. I am, however, a provider of dongs. Things you can do online now, guys. If you're a whimsical, spontaneous explorer like me, use landlines. Not to be confused with landmines, which you should not use. The site matches a place on Earth to whatever you draw or drag, like this. It took me to Rhône-Alpes, France, which you can now click in the lower left-hand corner to see on Google Maps. You are now ready to book yourself a ticket and fly away in the plane you designed on How Things Fly. This cute video shows a plane being drawn, and now, it crashed. This is because to fly, you need to master lift, weight, thrust, and drag, which you can learn about on this page. Now that you know engines produce thrust and lift is created by differences in air pressure, it's time to make your own aircraft. You can manipulate the four forces and watch them in action. For lift, I can choose this wing, DC-3, but it isn't going as planned. Larger wings cause more drag and slow it down, so let's manipulate weight. Now, what would happen if a plane was made of wood? It's strong and lightweight, but we need more of it to build a durable vehicle, so this reduces lift, which makes altitude decline. Now that you are in tune with your inner aeronautical engineer, get in Toonator.com, where you can create a digital flipbook. You can see the marks from the previous slide, so you can accurately position your current drawing in relation to the prior one and make this stick figure's movements more realistic. Isn't it just mesmerizing? No. Well, maybe you need your vision checked on Essilor.com, which has no diagnostic value, but it's fun, so please join me. Cover one of your eyes and use your arrow keys to indicate which way the open side of the W is facing. You can also test your sensitivity to light here. Oh, would you look at that score? They don't call me Eye Socket Stevens for nothing. This test shows me that I am able to perceive small amounts of contrast, meaning I don't need a ton of light in order to see well, which is great, because I'm in the mood to take a walk in some shadowy woods right now on awaytogo.com. Take this square-headed dude on a peaceful walk through a forest by pressing W or E to run. The spacebar lets him jump and you can move your mouse to look around. Click to get a close-up view of things like, well, dirt or whatever this is. And I'm walking. Now I'm floating. Can I get down? Anyone? All right, well, let's leave him there and we'll go play filler. The goal is to fill up the space provided 2/3 of the way with the filler balls. You create them by clicking and holding. The longer you hold, the larger it becomes, but you cannot let the bouncy balls touch you while you are in the process of creating the filler balls. You are given a certain number of lives and balls, so be strategic. You're smart, of course, so I believe in you. And since we're putting your intelligence to the test, let's play the Simon Says memory game. It starts off easy, but then as the patterns get more and more complex, well, it stays easy because I remember everything. Like how ginger and fresh lemon can help with nausea, which will be important to know during Cube Runner, a game that takes you through a tunnel of squares with the occasional three-dimensional cube. You have to avoid these cubes by steering around them with your mouse or else you will lose. So either you lose or you puke. It's a win-win. That's it for all these dongs. I'm gonna get back underneath the covers and stay warm and cozy. I want you guys to have a healthy and safe rest of your 2016 and enjoy the new year and happy holidays. I love you all. And as always, thanks for watching. Bye.